Good evening, viewers, and welcome to yet another 5 minutes with ZICTA program, a program designed by the authority to ensure that we share information on what is happening in the ICT sector. As we know, the ICT sector is the anchor of all other sectors. It's a base and backbone of business processes and socio-economic development. With me is Edward Mulenga, our public relations officer, and my name is Mofiati Sala, the director of support services. Edward.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome to 5 minutes with ZICTA. Today we'll just give you an overview of what to look forward to in the upcoming episodes on 5 minutes with ZICTA.
Definitely, this program is really growing because we know that with the movement of the ICT sector, it is important that the stakeholders and consumers out there understand just what's happening in the sector. And you know, nowadays, this sector actually touches on a lot of other sectors that are important to the Zambian economy. We look at education, we look at health, we look at finance, we also look at agriculture, and that is very, very important. And you know, going forward with this program, we are going to bring in different people that we are working with closely to ensure that the Zambian economy keeps on moving forward and ICT sector or the ICT platform becomes the base for that development.
Of course, Mafia. As you are aware, ZICTA's mission statement is to effectively provide regulatory services in the ICT sector in order to enhance access to quality ICT services for all. So, in line with this, we like to transcend across all sectors, like you earlier mentioned.
Definitely, but also, you know, we have to understand that the youth today in Zambia is very, very important, and government and His Excellency the President has constantly talked about creating jobs and ensuring that the youth today become busy. Say that you are an entrepreneur or you are an employee, and it is very important. I just want you to share a little bit with the viewers on just where you're coming from.
Yes. As you're aware, at ZICTA, we recently launched the Young ICT Innovation Program. This is a deliberate program by ZICTA in order to encourage production of new products and services that are ICT-based on the Zambian market. You know that youths are very avid users of ICTs nowadays, be it on mobile, on computers, and on different other platforms. The youths are very, very much active. And we recognize this at ZICTA and we want to incapacitate them in order to provide those services on the market in Zambia.
Definitely, definitely. But also, just share with the viewers, you were actually somewhere where you went to attend a conference for the youth?
Yes, I was. Most recently, I attended the Young ICT Leaders Forum. It was held in Busan, South Korea. This was a platform for all young ICT leaders across the world to apply and be selected to apply to attend that forum. You might be aware that in Africa, I was amongst the only three Africans that attended
brilliant,
the forum.
Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. So we're doing something good. But also, you know, it is very, very important, as we share with the viewers out there on this program, that it is vital that we actually indicate, you know, whenever there's a problem in the ICT sector, ZICTA comes in the middle. Whenever the mobile service providers or other players are not happy, ZICTA is in the middle. When government is not happy with the progress of ICT, ZICTA is in the middle. And since we're in the center of all things, it is important that we share and make sure that all these target groups understand just what we do. For the consumer, we want to make sure that he gets quality service all the time on time. So we need to show people that we're working in tandem to ensure that the Zambian out there gets the very, very best. Not forgetting also, we just had a very big initiative program. And you know, going into the fourth quarter, I think we have a lot of other things that are coming up. The SIM card registration, I know a lot of people were very, very upset with us constantly reminding them to register, but it was for their own good. As a cyberspace where they're doing all these things, the mobile phone or digital you know, device has become the center of transaction that we want to make sure that Zambians are well protected. And this is also something that we are going to touch on going forward. But however, I would also want to tell people that where there is a bigger program, there usually are bigger bottlenecks. You know that 11.9 subscriptions are on the table when it comes to SIM card registration, and that's a big number.
It is a big number. I think we've come a very long way in terms of ICT regulation, universal access, and providing a quality environment for our key stakeholders and all investors in the country. We've done this locally and internationally as well. Most recently, I think people would like to know that Zambia was elected to chair the seat at the Pan-African Postal Union. They're chairing the seat on regulation, strategy and policy. This is perhaps from the backdrop that we've done very well locally with the numbering and street addressing project.
Yeah, of course, that's another. But also we have to tell the viewers that as we speak now, part of a team from Foreign Affairs, part of a team from the Ministry of Transport and Communication and ZICTA are actually in Turkey, and we are vying for another seat under the Universal Postal Union. And if we get that seat, it means that we put this country on the map, just like any other African countries that are sharing bigger position on the world arena. But those are things that we're going to touch on in the next program, isn't it, Edward?
Of course.
So for now, I would like to tell the viewers that thank you very much for spending time with us. We'll see you next week at the same time. And thanks for sitting with us and listening to the program.